Hi, this is Professor Jen Mei Chen at California State University, Long Beach. In this video, we will look at a few examples where it's natural to use the logarithmic functions to model. When a physical quantity varies over a very large range, for example, if you consider the weight of an elephant versus the weight of an ant, the range is quite big. And it is often convenient to take its logarithm, for example, the log of the weight, in order to work with more reasonable numbers. On a log scale, numbers are represented by their logarithms. Let's consider four types of different animals and their weight. We have ant, elephant, whale, and human. Let's consider me as the representative of the human. Suppose the average weight for each of those four types of animal is given in kilogram. Let's figure out the log scale for each of those animals. For the ant, its weight is 0.000003 with 5 zeros, which can then be converted into the scientific notation of 3 times 10 to the negative 6. We take the log of 3 times 10 to the negative 6, then we can use property of the log, which turns the log of a product into the sum of the two logs. I have log 3 plus log 10 to the negative 6. With another property of the log, I can bring that negative 6 down to turn it into a negative 6 times log 10. We also know that log 10 is equal to 1, so this expression reduces down to log 3 minus 6, which with the calculator response approximates out to be about negative 5.5. Go ahead and take a moment to try to complete the rest of the log scales for the other three animals. An average elephant, which weighs about 4,000 kilograms, its log scale comes out to be about 3.6. A whale, which weighs about 170,000 kilograms, its log scale comes out to be about 5.2. And for me, my dream weight at 55 kilograms, log scale comes out to be about 1.7. If we plot those numbers on the log scale, we'll see that the ant, which has the log scale of negative 5.5, should appear to the leftmost. And then it comes me, which is 1.7, to the right of the ant. Then we have the elephant, which is at 3.6, and the whale is at 5.2, which appears to the rightmost on the scale. So instead of comparing values that is as small as 0.000003 and as big as 170,000, it's now much more easily and reasonable to compare values that is like negative 5.5 versus 5.2. So the log scale basically brings all these numbers closer on a range that is more reasonable. Another example of a physical situation that is modeled by the log scale is called the pH scale. The purpose of the pH scale is to describe the hydrogen ion concentration measured in moles per liter and denoted by this capital M, such in a way that numbers of different orders of magnitude can be compared graphically in order to avoid very small and negative exponents. pH scale is defined to be the negative log of the hydrogen ion concentration. Recall, graph of a negative log looks like this picture, which means that for numbers that are less than 1, its log value, which means its function value, is always going to be positive. That's this portion of the picture. And the smaller of that value, the bigger of its log value is going to be. For example, if the hydrogen ion concentration is 10 to the negative 4, I plug it into this formula for the pH value, I get negative log 10 to the negative 4. Which after some calculation gives you the value of 4. So we're guaranteed to have a positive output value for the pH, and again, the smaller of the iron concentration is, the bigger that positive value is going to be. At this scale, solutions with a pH of 7 are defined as neutral. Those with pH value less than 7 are acidic, and those with the pH value of greater than 7 are basic. We also notice that one unit increase in pH value corresponds to the hydrogen ion concentration decreases by a factor of 10. And this is because that for every one unit of pH, by definition, equal to negative log of some value x. And if we solve for x, we get that x is equal to 1 over 10, and that corresponds to a decrease by a factor of 10. Let's look at a few examples of the pH calculations. For example, I tell you that the hydrogen ion concentration for human blood is 3.16 times 10 to the negative 8 moles per liter. What is its pH value? Well, the pH by definition is negative log of H plus, which is 3.16 times 10 to the negative 8. And remember, all of this is inside the logarithm. To apply the rule of the logarithm to turn this product of a single log into the sum of two logs, then we have the negative quantity log 3.16 plus log of 10 to the negative 8. Then use another property of the log to rewrite this portion here into negative 8 times log base 10, 10. We also know that log base 10, 10 is equal to 1. This expression really reduces down to negative 8. Altogether, we have negative quantity log of 3.16 minus 8. Calculator response gives about 7.5. Since this value is greater than 7, we say that this solution is basic. Let's consider another type of example. If I tell you that the most acidic rainfall ever measured occurred in Scotland in 1974, its pH was 2.4. What is its hydrogen iron concentration? In this case, I know that the pH is 2.4 to start. What I don't know is its H value. So this gives me the negative log of desired H plus value. Using this H plus notation might cause some sort of a confusion later on when you're manipulating symbols. So let's just replace that with X. Rewriting the right-hand side gives me log of X raised to the negative 1. To get rid of the log, I need to apply the exponential function of base 10 both sides. This gives me 10 to the 2.4 is equal to x to the negative 1. If I wanted to isolate x, I would just raise both sides by the power of negative 1. By the rule of exponential function, those two negative 1s turns into a positive 1, which gives me the desired x. On the left-hand side, I simply just have 10 to the negative 2.4. Putting this into a calculator gives me an approximation of 4 times 10 to the negative 3 moles per liter, which is capital M. Another example of a physical phenomenon that can be modeled using a log function is the Richter scale. The magnitude M of an earthquake is defined to be, this definition was given by American geologist Charles Richter in 1935, log I over S, where I is defined to be the intensity of the earthquake. That is measured by the amplitude of the seismograph reading 100 kilometers from the epicenter of the quake. And S is the intensity of a standard earthquake whose amplitude is 1 micron, and 1 micron is equal to 10 to the negative 4 centimeters. This definition implies that the magnitude of a standard earthquake is 0. In addition, an earthquake of a magnitude M is 10 times stronger than the earthquake of a magnitude M minus 1. For example, an earthquake of magnitude 6 is 10 times stronger than an earthquake of magnitude 5. Let's look at an example of a Richter scale. The 1906 earthquake in San Francisco had an estimated magnitude of 8.3 on the Richter scale. In the same year, a powerful earthquake occurred on the Colombia and Ecuador border that was 4 times as intense. What was the magnitude of that earthquake on the Richter scale? Let's try to write on what we know. We know that the magnitude of the San Francisco earthquake was 8.3. By definition, the magnitude is defined to be the log of the intensity of the San Francisco quake divided by the standard quake, S. We also know that the Colombia-Ecuador earthquake was 4 times as intense as the San Francisco quake. I can write down the relationship in terms of the I's. It means I of the Colombia-Ecuador earthquake is 4 times as much as the intensity of the San Francisco quake. Now, if I wanted to compute the magnitude of the Colombia and Ecuador quake, I will use its definition, which is the log of the intensity of CE divided by the S, which is the standard quake. Because I know from the previous relationship that the ICE is 4 times of ISF, I can rewrite this into 4 ISF divided by S. Using a property of the log, I can split this into a log of 4 plus log of ISF divided by S. Because notice that this is really just 4 times the ISF divided by S. I already know what the log of ISF over S is, and that is just 8.3. So this calculation reduces down to the log of 4 plus 8.3, which estimates about 8.9 on the calculator. Let's look at another example of the Richter scale. We know that the 1989 Loma Prieta earthquake that shook San Francisco had a magnitude of 7.1 on the Richter scale. How many times more intense was the 1906 earthquake with a magnitude of 8.3 than the 1989 event? The question is asking you to compare intensity of the two quakes. In essence, we're looking for this quantity of the intensity of the 06 earthquake over the intensity of the 89 earthquake. If we know the magnitude of the O6 event is 8.3, which by definition is equal to the log of the intensity of O6 divided by the standard quake S, the magnitude of the 89 event is 7.1, which is the log of the intensity of the 89 divided by S. What we're going to do is cleverly write this ratio of I06 over I89 using kind of the information we have. Okay, so we're going to think of the I06 divided by I of 89 as the I06 divided by S times the S over I89. The reason why this doesn't change is because the S kind of cancels in this process. But this is also the same as to think it's I06 divided by S, all divided by the I89 divided by S. Because remember, division by a fraction is a multiplication by its reciprocal. So in order to find something about the ratio of I06 over I89, it's equivalent to actually look at the ratio of the I06 over S divided by the I89 over S. If I take the log of this more complicated ratio, then I can use this property of the logarithm, which says that the log of a quotient is the same as the difference of the two logs. And that allows me to break this log into log of I06 divided by S minus log of I89 over 6. And this is really good news to us because I actually know what log of I06 over S is, and that is just 8.3. Same thing, I actually know what log of I89 over S is, and that is just 7.1. I simply just get 8.3 minus 7.1, which is a 1.2. This is telling me that the log of this complicated ratio is equal to 1.2. And remember, this complicated ratio is really the same ratio as what we're looking for. This translates to saying the log of I06 over I89 is equal to 1.2. Isolate this ratio, all I need to do is undo the log, which is applying the exponential function of base 10 to both sides. So this gives me my desired ratio I06 over I89 equals 10 to the 1.2, which comes out to be about 16, my calculator response. What this means is that the 1906 earthquake was about 16 times as intense as the 1989 earthquake.